What's up, YouTube family? Welcome to another episode of Life with Jen and CG. Another week, another crazy-ass episode. We want to, first off, give a big shout-out to Bel Air Headquarters. We are going to be pouring some Vion, and this is from France, black-owned. So we're gonna pour this up, and I'm going to smell it before I sip it, because, you know, I'm not really a cognac drinker, but...
Oh, it's a cognac.
Yeah, this is a cognac, so it's Vion. I'm not sure. I think I know who's over it, but I'll put it in the description. I don't want to throw it out there.
Well, shout out to Vion.
Shout out to you. Another, of course, before we get into episode 6 of this new season of Basketball Wives.
We're halfway through, Lord of Mercy.
Part 2 of My True Scam Story aired yesterday, and it was heartfelt. It was super dope, and I love what Jennifer did at the end for all the victims. So, once again, shout out to you, babe, for, you know, standing up and speaking your truth and bringing awareness to the situation. And it's a wrap, and it's like everybody's reaching out like this needs to be a Lifetime movie. I'm thinking it should be a Netflix special, but you know, I reach for the stars and people reaching, they grabbing rocks. I'm like,
no, yeah. I just want to say, like, I'm actually really proud of myself, because this project took, it was always something. There was always an obstacle, and you know, when you're dealing with something like a legal matter, it was a lot of headache, but to get to the end of the road and to actually get the project done and get the awareness out there, it was just like, I can't even describe my feelings. But honestly, I don't want to stop there. I do want to tell other people's story. And I think it's just a topic that we need to talk about in the community, because it does happen all the time. And you could see the expert, Benita, she said it's $1.3 billion that people have lost due to love scams. So this is a big thing. And I don't think it should stop with my story. I feel like I can continue to tell people's story. And you know, when you have gone through something, you just feel like more comfortable talking to a person that can relate. So I just really want to tell people it's okay to stand in your truth and tell your story. And you didn't do anything wrong. You know, it's like we like to blame the victim, and that's horrible. But yes, part 2 aired. You saw his dad. It's like, damn, you still from your own dad. This man was meeting men on Jacked. I mean, it was just absolutely crazy. You saw his daughter, Dallas. I mean, just like,
what? He was meeting men on Jacked, scamming the men, also being intimate with the men. It was like, it got super crazy. Like, they were talking about, I'm not going to get inappropriate on this channel. Y'all can look deeper into it, but I'm just saying it. There was a form of intimacy with these men. So,
I mean, it was just, the story is crazy. I'm glad I was able to tell it. I feel like we have got good feedback.
Yeah.
And you know, there's going to be some haters. We love y'all too, but
y'all know that.
Yeah, of course. So no, I'm proud. And I'm happy that I was able to tell my story under Jennifer Williams Productions. Come on, EP credit. I have a movie coming out. So it's like, I don't want to stop here. Yes, I can make this into a movie, because honestly, you didn't even hear like 1/10 of the people that I spoke to in regards to this same man. And I get it. Everybody's not comfortable sitting with a camera in your face talking about you got scammed. It's a lot. So I think
those people should get, and that's why I believe this should be ongoing. I think I know you're going to continue to press the issue.
Absolutely.
Because I feel like there are people, even though there's people that's camera shy, I believe there are people that want, after seeing this, they probably built the courage to say, you know what, I'm ready to tell my story.
Yeah. Sometimes, like I said on the documentary, you're not going to get justice through the Justice Department. Like, look at what happened to me and how much of an asshole that the prosecutor was.
Behind the scenes, though. the 50,000 behind the scene.
And here's the thing. When you're a victim, they're supposed to have some type of correspondence with you, right? And I have reached out to this man. My attorney reached out to this man. I called. I sent emails. And it was like some real crooked shit that was going down at Cobb County Superior Court. Yes, I'm calling y'all the fuck out. So my thing is this. If you can't get justice from the Justice Department, still speak your truth. And I always say, regardless of what has happened, document it. Go to the police. Now, I'm not going to get too much into the police because I feel like they didn't do shit either. But the court system did pick up the case. Unfortunately, you know, it didn't turn out the way I wanted to. But I still say you still have to report these things.
For sure. You have to. I mean, at the end of the day, it creates paper trail. And, you know, at the end of the day, my take on everything is you can't beat karma. You can't beat the law of the universe, the law of life.
And it's
you can't
warming beat it. Up to serve his ass.
Yeah.
Everybody gets served karma. Yeah. For sure.
Yeah. I believe if you scamming people, you should have a better watch game. You know, because the niggas watch game is horrible. It was like, I don't know if you ever seen them big ass watches that you can get from the Citgo gas station. I'm like, bro, it's and it's crazy because you made a comment at the end. And it was kind of like, you mumbled it, but you said it. You were just like, I wonder who he robbed to get the check.
Absolutely.
To pay you restitution, which wasn't nearly enough. It was just like, damn.
Yeah, like, what? Please, if I could find a Range Rover for 50,000, like, it's like, really?
2003. No, we talking.
It's just like, it's so ridiculous. But again, this is, you know, our justice system. And it failed me, but guess what? I didn't fail myself. Yeah. So I feel like I got my justice because I was able to tell my story.
Yeah. So now it's huge. I keep telling you that it's huge. I'm just sitting there watching. I'm just like, damn, like she did this. She put out her own money to make this, bring this vision to life. And it happened. And, you know, there's so much more work that she is going to do. And it's going to turn into something bigger. Like, I'm looking at it and it looked like an episode of Dateline. I'm like,
yeah. Damn. And shout out to Half Yards, my production company that I partner with. I just think they did a phenomenal job with the editing. I was really pleased. So what you guys don't know is because, yes, I was executive producer, but I was also technically a victim. So I couldn't be sitting in the editing room because it's basically illegal. So I had to kind of just be very hands off, which was hard for me because I'm like, oh my God, this is like my passion project, my baby. I've been like watching it grow. Yeah. So that was a little difficult, but I commend Half Yards. They did a great job, and I felt like they handled it delicately and with care.
Yes. Super proud.
So I guess we can talk about Arizona, hot ass Arizona. So sure the episode was
we're halfway through.
We're halfway there. We're at the halfway mark. So I was on the fence about going to Arizona because one, I just didn't want to be around this chick, Kleana. I just feel like she has bad energy. I'm trying to always protect my energy. And, you know, these trips, it's just always going to be some drama. So, of course, Jackie wanted me to go on the trip. And actually, you and I were on a trip when the episode first opened up for your grandmother's birthday.
And you flew straight. You flew back to LA and then flew straight there.
Yes, yeah. Which was, like, so crazy. I knew I was going to go because, one, it was a celebration for Brooke. But I definitely was on the fence at one point, but I was like, okay, you know what? Brooke has been through a lot. Obviously I want to be there for her. I knew it was like her birthday thing. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna take myself out of this and be selfless. And this is about Brooke, not me. So I ended up going to Arizona and, it was a shit show.
It was a surprise when you walked up. We're like, damn, you pulled up. They weren't expecting you to come because situations like that happen, you disassociate yourself real quick. So, you know, you pulled up and.
Evelyn knew I was there.
Yeah, you walked in, it was already tension going on between There was an argument that
prior to, I believe this is what happened. So prior to me walking into the pool party, there was an argument with Giselle and Kleana.
Yes.
And see, here's the thing. Like, this girl, Kleana, is just, she is off her rocker in real life. And so she got into an argument with Giselle, and she's saying something about Giselle's ring. It's like, girl, you have no rings, never got a ring. Like, really? It's just inappropriate. Like, why would you say anything about this girl's ring? Like, what?
I think it's poor behavior and just shaming black love and black marriage anyway. I don't care.
Well, I mean, when you've been a groupie all your life, I guess you don't know anything about black love.
You know, it's always deeper for me. You know, they always talk about the material stuff, but I'm just like, damn, you like, where,
right?
It's like you really are that miserable where you gotta comment on a ring and
people's happiness. Like, just be happy for people.
That's it.
And my thing is like, listen, it might not be your time, but your time will come around. You still got to clap for people when it's their time. That's one thing I always say. Pay attention when you're winning to who's clapping and who's looking with the screw face.
That's a big fact.
You know what I'm saying?
Take note.
Yeah, because it's like, oh, you're really like a secret hater.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's a bar. Because I'm very observant.
And let me tell you something. It could be friends. It could be family. Everybody is not happy for you, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Right? So it's like you have to take note of these things. Now, granted, this girl is not a friend or family. We still don't know where she came from. But it's like, why are you hating on this girl, her relationship? It's just, she has no etiquette. So I guess, it's to be expected. But it's just unfortunate.
I believe she went on a trip to make her attacks. Whether it be physical or verbally.
Well, here's the thing.
It was Giselle, then it became Brooke.
And right, that's what I was just about
you
to
just,
say.
You just jumped.
No, she's going down the line. So she gets into it with Giselle. Then she gets into it with, did she get into it with, I don't know if she got into it with Brittany, but she definitely got into it with Brooke. That's how she ended up getting carried out. And she got into it with Vanessa. I mean, listen, you already know how I feel about her, but.
They operate in the same headspace. So I think it's cool for them to argue over here and then let y'all do what y'all do over there.
Well, here's right. So here's the thing. They were arguing about some shit that they were going back and forth on text about being messy, talking about people.
You know what's so funny though? Because, you know, it was, I think it was Ev speaking about it. She was like, all right, we're waiting on these receipts, whatever. And it's like, she going through her phone looking for the receipts. And then she like, yeah, I got the receipts. And I'm dying on the inside because I'm like, in my head, I'm like, I know you don't have receipts because it don't take that long. Then she was like, oh, yeah, it was sent over the phone. I'm like, yo, you're like, if you got the receipts, it's receipts. It's in black and white, right? She was like, oh, no, that part was sent over the phone. Like, come on, who's believing that, right? Like, it's so crazy. You could read right through that. You know what I'm saying? But
no, yeah, because I'm going to tell you what happened. Those girls, they got on the phone. They got in a group chat or whatever and decided that they were going to come for all the OGs, right? And so now they're getting called out about their actions and people trying to, like, pull up receipts. Like, no, y'all were on this mission together to come for us. And it's like, we ain't checking for y'all. Yeah. Like, we actually were trying to embrace those girls. And so they started acting crazy. And Vanessa started out the gate, so...
I mean, it's every episode for her.
I mean, it's like, you know, I saw some comments on Twitter and they were like, oh my God, like she's so obsessed with Jennifer and Evelyn. I'm like, yeah, because you don't want to deal with your own shit. Like you have a life, live it. You're so worried about ours. It's crazy. Yeah. I never seen somebody that is so invested in someone else. And my thing is like, we're not friends with you. So it's not even like you could say, oh, well, this is my girl. And I'm like, girl, we don't know you. We're not friends with you. You're doing too much.
Yeah.
And I have a problem with, like you said, with the situation with Kleana. It's like you see people happy in love, let it be. Like, who are you to try and, like, diminish somebody's happiness? Like, it just speaks volumes about who you are, because you're so miserable and you want everybody to live in this misery with you. It's not happening. Like, bitch, there's nothing you could tell me about my man, my man, my man that I don't know. It's just ridiculous.
I believe it. Even if I don't know you, I see things all the time about people being happy. I clap for them. I ain't got to kick it with you, but I'm happy for you. It's like, cool. Be happy, keep it moving, and we good. Everybody's good, right? So, I don't even, what else happened? Honestly, all I saw episode 6 was just argument here. It was just a bunch of just argue. I'm just like, yo, where's the peace?
And then you see Cleanna walk into the pool party. We did like skip. A bad cloud.
Yeah, we did miss over the part because, you know, even I think also before you showed up, Brooke and Brittany had a conversation. It kind of made their differences.
Yes. So I will say, Brittany did take accountability for her being drunk at the ice skating rink, and she realized that she was wrong. And you know, you have to clap for that.
Right? I can respect it.
Yeah, because it's like, listen, you were wrong, and you spoke your truth, you stood in your truth, you admitted you were wrong, and you apologized. So it's like she took accountability. So again, I applaud her for stepping up and doing that. That was a good moment.
Good job, Brittany. Good. I don't know you, but good job.
So yeah, I just feel like it was a lot of arguing this episode. Next episode,
there's probably more arguing because I don't think the trip is over. I personally don't know.
Well, they showed in a preview, I'm not giving this away, they did show me confronting Vanessa.
You and Evelyn.
Yeah, so that goes down.
One thing I say about Evelyn, boy, if Jen got some shit going, Evelyn step in quick. And then, Ev, if you watching this, I know when you get upset because that damn vein pop up. Right there.
Well, so the crazy thing is that, so when we're in Arizona, Evelyn is the one that tells me all the shit that Vanessa's been saying.
Yeah.
Right? And I'm like, what? So it was like only right that she would come with me to confront her because she had to like, yeah, bitch, you did say X, Y, and Z. So I don't know what they're going to show, but they did show in the preview part of my conversation with her. And Arizona, there's some more things that happen. It gets very interesting.
It's already too hot in Arizona to be arguing.
Oh my God. Can I just talk about how hot it was in Arizona? Babe, I swear the minute you walked outside, you just wanted to go back inside and take a shower. It was just like sweat would just pour off of you. And it was a heat wave, and it was also a warning.
Yeah.
You could literally, I'm not even joking, guys, you could fry an egg on the sidewalk. That's how hot it was. I'm like, why y'all pick to go to Arizona? Like, really? It's already hot. Bitches is mad. Is you add the heat? It's just too much.
That was sticky right there. That was sticky.
There were some good parts of Arizona, I feel. Hopefully they layer that in. Like, I thought the Brittany moment with Brooke was a good layer of
Brooke's pool party good. It was cool until
it was good into the black.
She walked in and she
no, it was
didn't
like you
hello.
Saw you saw a black cloud come through.
She
like
walked through.
How do you walk into somebody's party?
Don't say anything.
You don't speak. You know it's a birthday party. At least speak to the birthday girl. Like, the hell with us. I don't care if you speak to me, because, bitch, I'm not talking to you.
No, because she sat there and said, oh, no, me and Jen, we good. And it's crazy because, boom, they panned to you, and you was just like, what you mean?
Yeah.
No apologies.
My thing is,
we don't talk. Like, what's
right.
Going on?
How do you say we're good? Like, first of all, you don't get to determine if we're good. You put your hands on me, not the other way around. Now you're trying to say we're good. No, bitch, we're not good at all, actually. So
mental health is serious.
Like, I'm like, now how did I get in this, girl? Because I'm not in this. We are not good, and we still don't know where you came from.
Yeah, it's cooking though. It's cooking, but the season, as we gradually go through this every single Monday, it starts to get better. It's a lot of things that I think y'all are going to be happy about as far as, you know, Jennifer with you know, with the girls, Brooke Evelyn, Jackie. I think everything starts to, you know, kind of smoothing itself out. Right now, we at the core.
We on Rocky Road right now.
We at the core of it, going into episode 7. And like I said, I'm excited to watch the rest of the season.
It's been going like this.
Yeah.
So we're right here at the arc, and hopefully it'll be like,
I'm just here to protect my peace and our peace. And
maybe, absolutely.
Maybe someday we'll get the Jen and CG show of it. I'm sure that it'll happen soon. You know, we have a pretty dope life that we live. So
no, we do. It's amazing. And who knows?
Who knows?
But we have some great things in the future that I'm excited about. We have our engagement party coming up. And so we have good things in the works. But this is not about us, for real. But I thought the episode was just, it was a lot of arguing. There was, like I said, a good moment with the Brittany and Brooke situation. And yeah, Arizona gets more and more interesting. So next episode, I don't know. I don't know what they're going to show. Oh, they did show us on a preview at the Shaman. So that was cool. But we'll talk about that on the next recap.
And
I had never been to a Shaman.
Real life question. I didn't ask you. And I'm not trying to be petty. Was the room good? Was the room okay? Because it wasn't last season.
You know what?
The room was
good. So we stayed at the Andaz in Scottsdale.
That's a Hilton property, right?
I don't know, babe.
Andaz is owned by Hilton.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, it was super cute. I had a bungalow. Remember I showed you? I had a huge bathroom. It was the outdoor area, which I didn't want to be outside because it was so goddamn hot. And then in front of my bungalow, it was a area where you could sit outside as well. But it was like too hot. Gotcha. You know, like I just always, even at that pool party, it was steaming. I had to sit in a pool. They didn't show that part, but I was just like, okay, I'm going to sit my ass in a pool because it was hot. It was so hot, even at night. I was so happy I had that bob because I was like, listen, the hair, But
She walked out with that bathing suit.
I had my Chanel bathing suit on that my man brought me. It was so cute. I had it all head to toe Chanel look, darling. Had to do something for the kids.
I bought it or you stole my credit card.
No, I'm not a scammer. I don't steal, babe.
I mean, my thing is it's not stealing. You just probably snuck it out my wallet. I mean,
no, babe. You bought it.
I'm just playing.
Oh, I'm like, what?
No, I was happy to see her wear it because we just had a conversation yesterday.
It's oh, like, my God.
I bought her all this shit and she don't wear it. It's like,
Jennifer
got tags on maybe 100 different items that she just won't wear. It's like, and then she'll go shop for more. But that's a topic for another discussion. But I think that's pretty much it. Almost at season 6. Season 11, episode 6 of the show. I think that was pretty much it.
Yeah, it was just a lot of arguing this episode. But next episode, I feel like it's a little more. There's a little more like meat and potatoes.
Yeah, it starts to get real greasy. Yeah. Based off the conversations we've had, I don't know what they're gonna show, but
yeah, I don't. Listen, I don't know. We saw parts of the preview, so who knows? You know, sometimes I look at the edits and I'm like, why y'all show that part and not the other part? So I don't know what they're doing over there. But yes, that was episode 6. Those are my thoughts on episode 6. And I guess stay tuned for episode 7.
But before episode 7, we got a little surprise for y'all. So I'm going to go ahead and tell y'all in this video, we're actually, your wishes and whatever has been granted. Because I know in the comments, y'all were like, we want to see the progress of the engagement, the party, whatever. Jennifer getting her dress for the reunion that's coming up. So we're working on that, and we look forward to dropping that for you guys. Of course, it's literally behind the scenes of her working with her designer in London. And, of course, me, you know, getting ready as well for our engagement party coming up. So that's pretty much a wrap for episode 6 of Basketball Wives. And once again, shout out to Bel Air headquarters and Vion. Of course, y'all see it lit up behind us.
Yeah,
very special cognac for all my cognac drinkers. So this is pretty much in every liquor store that you pass. It's crazy because we were somewhere and I saw the bottle. I think it was at a bar, whatever. We eat out every day, so I don't remember the restaurant.
The Violet McQueen.
The McQueen and the Violet Fog, which is Wiz Khalifa's. All my gin drinkers, you probably will like that as well. So that's a wrap. And
make sure you guys like, subscribe, turn on those notifications, and we will see you on the next episode of Jen and CG.